percent of our hero, and every time that it gets to an enemy, the fight will automatically occur. I have it set so that it will pause after each fight. You can hit spacebar or right click to resume, basically. So in the planning phase, you can lay down cards or, you know, change your equipment, that kind of thing. So I am going to equip nine items here. So vampirism is kind of like life drain. And I'm not quite sure about the magic damage. That might be like damage that gets through no matter what. I'm not entirely sure. Okay, the cemetery is kind of tough, but why not? So when you lay down a card, it'll tell you what it does down here. So this one spawns a skeleton every 3 days. The days are up here. You'll hear a little rooster crowing when the new day begins, and different things will happen based on, you know, like sometimes you get more health at the beginning of a day, or sometimes different enemies spawn. These are just little basic. These are basic slimes. Any of the kind of plain road tiles can spawn a slime at a 5% rate. So the slimes are pretty easy, but also, so this is our loop. And so our camp is right here. It doesn't always go in a clockwise motion, but it's kind of random based on the game is going. So when I get here, I will get some resource probably, I think. And also, if something has spawned there by the time we get there, then we might have a little fight. Okay, so when you grab the card, it will show you where you can play it. Now, since I've been playing this for a while, square of rocks and mountains is a good thing to have because it gives you extra hit points. Man, I am so tired. Hopefully this will make you tired as well. Okay, so I like to put these over here. So I'm just going to start with the middle. Now once you have a resource, so this also gives you pebbles. Resources are in very small shards at a time. So I'm going to, if you put that out, you can see what you're getting. I like to see what I'm getting. Okay, so we had a new day. We got some pebbles. We've got a slime. Alright, the battlefield is pretty fun, so you could have ghosts be spawned. Also gives you a treasure chest, so I like to put this there's a little chest. It can be a mimic, but it's not. I like evasion and defense better than the vampirism. When you place a new item, the other one just kind of gets destroyed or goes away. So this is the tutorial one, and it's really not that hard, as you would expect. I just find this to be a really cool and relaxing kind of game that's surprisingly good. The music is really good too, but unfortunately, I couldn't figure out a good recording set up for that in my first foray into screen recording. I'm sure that I have some people in my, amongst my subscribers who could help me a little bit with that. Okay, so the spider cocoon is another good one to get some experience, but I don't want to put it right here because then stuff out here, or you can delete a tile. Okay, let's get some vampires now. Let's do vampires and spiders. So, similarly to the ghost aura, this has a little area of effect where it will add a vampire to the fights. Thank you. that family don't have enough food to survive, so she has to come and kill people, I guess, basically, and attack us. We're generally a very diplomatic type of person, so Mopsy just wants them to do well, he or she. Every 2 days, and it will kind of come to a random place on the loop. Okay, I guess I'll let them in. Alright, so that pops open with all sorts, but just like how the mountain has the harpy, this spawns a gargoyle every few days. Alright, let's see what else we have going on here. Thank you.